Hi buddy, my name is Eric. I'm the organizing manager with the Korean Resource Center. This video is to give you the latest up-to-date information regarding the DACA decision by the Supreme Court. We want to make sure today's date is Tuesday, July 23rd, 2020. The reason for this date is because we want to make sure you get the latest information as well as be up to date on the latest information you have as of today. This is a very brief update. There's a lot of misinformation out there. We want to make sure you get the right information in the latest up-to-date way. So we're going to be talking about the DACA decision in three different ways. We're going to be talking about in terms of brief information regarding the decision, what to do now, as well as the frequently asked questions. Supreme Court Justice ruled last Thursday 5-4 in favor of upholding the DACA program. The Justice John Roberts, Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg, Lena Kagan, Stephen Breyer and Sonia Sotomayor all ruled in favor of keeping the DACA program. The DACA requirements will be on the bottom in the link provided below in the description. The link is from the USCIA main office. Over 700,000 people in the United States have DACA, but this is out of 11 million undocumented people in the United States. What to do now? Renew. We tell folks to renew their DACA. If your DACA expires within the next 3 months, please renew ASAP. Even if it doesn't expire within the next 3 months, please be sure to contact and ask for further information regarding that. Advanced parole. Advanced parole allows folks who have DACA to travel outside the country, whether it is for academic reasons or even other personal reasons. There's many other reasons why you might be able to travel outside the country with advanced parole if you have DACA. We tell folks as of this moment, even though DACA is upheld, please do not plan to go outside the country as of yet. There's a chance that the ruling or there might be a new changes made by the Trump administration. So please be wary and put a hold on any future travel outside the country for this moment wait until further information will be released. First time applicants. We tell folks right up at this moment, the first time applicant should also wait until they get further information. The reason for this is because USCIS has been caught working with ICE. The first-time applicants may be in danger because when they file for DACA, they'll be telling ICE as well as USCIS. The first-time applicants will be telling USCIS as well as ICE now that where they'll be residing or where they're living. So it's extremely dangerous. So we ask the first-time applicants to wait until they get further information or to get latest up-to-date information regarding that. Frequently asked questions. These are some of the frequently asked questions asked by our community members who reaches out to us. Can Trump take away DACA? This question is really hard to answer only because we don't know what the future may hold or what the Trump administration might do. We have some idea that what it could happen because of this DACA decision made by the Supreme Court. The DACA decision might be going down to lower courts. Also, the Trump administration might try to do what they can to take away DACA, but the chances are it's a lot harder now because of the Supreme Court decision. DACA, it was never a pathway to citizenship. It was only a temporary status. So DACA, just because you have DACA, does not guarantee you a pathway to citizenship. So with that, please stay informed and follow us on KRC with the latest up-to-date information. Follow us on our social media, Instagram, Facebook, and YouTube. And be sure to check us on our website where we update regularly. Thank you so much for watching. Hope to see you again next time.